Gary Freeman leads this side out. They are hell-bent on turning around the international scene, starting with a win here at Olympic Park. Very cool, calm and collected. A nice slow walk out, no doubt, to soak up this atmosphere of this Melbourne arena. The famous black and white strip. They're coming off a successful series against France, but I wonder also, Lowy, if that French series is really the right build-up to meet Australia.
Well, that's what everyone says, Graham, but like, these guys know what the game's all about. So I'll come up with the business tonight. Don't worry about that. They had to win those games, and they did it.
Tonight, the Australian National Anthem will be performed by Debbie Byrne.
Standing by for the National Anthems.
Any moment now.
Miss Debbie Byrne, the Australian National
and
Anthem.
And now the New Zealand National Anthem to be performed by Kim Hart.
And now another emotional moment. Stand by, New Zealand, for your own National Anthem. Freeman, he is pumped up, and the hearts are beating faster, and that lady from Ellerslie, Kim Hart, really has things fired up. The famous Harker about to be put before the Kiwis' victory on mine.
I just want to tell New Zealand, Graham, the Kiwis in this crowd have done New Zealand proud. It's a great start for us already. There's plenty of New Zealand support here. There's an unbelievable atmosphere. The mood is right for Australia to be plucked right out of this game. And I reckon the look on those guys' faces when they came out, they are in the frame of mind to do it.
Well, Bob Bailey and the Kiwi bench just as nervous. No doubt about it.
A lot of pressure being on Bob. You know, he had a tough start last year, Graham. Well, I'm very, very impressed with the manner in which he's come up with this challenge this year. He's done a good job with these fellas. There's a lot of brave selections out there. There's been a lot of criticisms of the New Zealand side. But when it comes to the crunch, we all back the team. And everybody is behind Bob. I can assure New Zealand that he's done a good job with them. The way they look today in the hotel, I thought was fantastic. They're in a good frame of mind. And we're just going to have to see if they can carry out the job.
Well, it is a privilege to be able to join you all on Three for this exclusive coverage through Mobile Sport of this Cadbury Morrow test. These two countries first met back in 1908, and that series was won by New Zealand 2-1. 64 encounters, Australia dominate. And now, all the talk, all the hype, all the training routines are out the window as we're down to action. Look out for things to blow up in the forwards early. Lidner. And the Kiwis flying in defence. Twos and threes down on the Australian 22. Pictures, of course, courtesy of the Seven Network in Australia. As Steve Walters ducks straight up the middle and sneaks about 20 metres. The Kiwis with a man down, out injured. So they're down to 12 for the moment. Gene Lonergan really heavily concussed. As a penalty comes to the Australians for inside the five. He's in a bad way, really struggling.
He is a bad way, Graham. It's unfortunate now, to see that so early.
Now, Gary Freeman has made that aware to John Holdsworth. Play is supposed to continue unless the referee thinks it is such a bad injury that a doctor might be needed. But he has continued on with the action as Australia in the opening moments. And the Kiwis minus Lonergan. They defend their 22. Bella it is who charged into them. The ball thrown across Roach. It was a difficult one for Ian Roberts to handle. Right in midfield. The ball's been stolen. John Holdsworth says that he's not going to muck around. And another penalty comes very quickly. Now this is the incident of Lonergan putting his head in the wrong position. He put his head right in front of Roach and he took a shoulder and a forearm and he ended up in Disneyland.
Well, that's a shame, Graham, but he is sitting up now, but I don't think there's no changes are going to be made. I think the message has come across, they're okay. But unfortunately, that's been followed up now by a silly penalty. The Kiwis have been warned, no stealing the ball, and it was quite obvious they did that. They're back there whinging about it, but they've got to make sure that they listen to what they were told.
Mal Meninga, who has 46 points in International Rugby League against New Zealand, one try and 21 goals, the Australian captain from just outside the 22 to try and draw first blood. A lasting look at the post. A deep breath for the Australian captain. A couple of short paces, but he sprays it wide. So a let-off celebration for the Kiwis, and Lonergan still struggling on his feet as being taken to the sideline. Bob Bailey will have to get somebody stripped. So what a disappointing start for New Zealand. The first couple of tackles and one of their important back rowers. And he's trying to get George Mann, it looks like, out there as quickly as possible. Lonergan taken back to the bench. He wants to get back on the field. Well, they can't muck around. They've got to get their complement of 13 back out there.
Well, they've got to make it. Someone's got to make a decision down there quickly. George is putting his coat back on again now. New Zealand's got to get 13 players on the field.
The long, tall drink of water. Paul Hoff, the fullback for Australia, making his test debut. And Bradley Clyde, back from some horrible knee surgery last season. Now he's back in a green and gold jumper. And Bobby Lidner takes it to the halfway line. Plenty of pace. Quick play of the balls. The defence moving up quickly. Lewis with the ball out to Chris Johns. Great defence from Watson. Now Meninga from dummy half. edges it towards the sideline. It's on the last tackle. Looking for the kicking game of Langer or Lewis. Langer to kick it away from Frano. Botica on the run. Well taken. He straightens up the middle. A little bit of a gap he's taken high by Ian Roberts. First chance with the ball for the Kiwis. And Todd, who will be doing a hell of a lot of work up the middle, takes his first charge. New Zealand, heavy defence coming in from Bob Lidner and Roach. Amazingly, Lonergan gets back out on the field. So he's regathered his senses. Enough now for Tony Kemp to get this kick in down away from big Paul Hoff. Plenty of chases from New Zealand. And Hoff will be trapped about 12 metres out.
Cameraman on the line.
Well, Huey McGahn, perfect playing conditions tonight here in Melbourne.
Graham, you couldn't have asked for a better night. New Zealand have started off on the wrong foot. Again, they go away with a penalty. You can't afford that in this type of football. They've got to get in there, put the pressure on them. What they're doing there, all they're doing is putting pressure on themselves. And Dean Lonergan, really, he doesn't look very good out there. He shouldn't be out there playing. He's cut. He's put his head in the wrong position, as you called earlier.
Lonergan has got back out there. Penalty 3-0 to the Australians.
Huey, don't you think that someone should be warming up on the sideline there for New Zealand to be ready to make the change if necessary?
Come back to Huey shortly as Kiwis come up with a scrum win. Now Watson, quick hands to McCracken. McCracken with a good ball away. Jason Williams goes back infield. But he's held by Lewis and Ettinghausen. Now charging onto it, Tawrea and Nikau. Out they go to the back line again. Kemp forced back up the middle. Watson is there. Good quick hands out to Botica. Botica stepping, turning out of the tackle. The Australians were short out there. If New Zealand could have got it out there quickly enough. Kemp, a little bit of variation over the top. Beats everybody over the sideline. But so much better as New Zealand settles down.
Yeah, congratulations, New Zealand. A fine start just to that passage of play. They brought it over to the grandstand side of the field here. They then drew in the whole Australian defence, offloaded it back out to the other side of the ground and caught Australia short-handed.
All right, well, let's take you back down sideline with Clinton, a report from that New Zealand bench.
Well, the word is from Dean Lonergan himself. He actually wants to go back out there. That's the reason why they haven't made a change, because he's had that cut on the back of his head attended to by the New Zealand team doctor and the physio, and he's determined to stick it out there on the paddock tonight to go for his gold medal here at Olympic Park.
Well, they're settled down now, but it's Australia searching out wide through Lewis, chased and harassed by Freeman. The dummy from Hoff, a bit of room up the middle. Good run from Hoff, 40 metres out from his own line. Last tackle. And a little knock on that will give New Zealand a chance here.
Good play, New Zealand. They forced an error then. That's what they want. They're slowly creeping into this game, and I think they're looking good and strong at this stage.
Bailey much more settled. A lot happier now. Play down the other end of the field and a chance for New Zealand. Kemp, McCracken. Young man going places from the Canterbury Club here in Sydney. And New Zealand received their first penalty. A ball that was stolen by Ian Roberts. Roberts doesn't seem to like it. Now, you heard so much about, as we see Roberts just getting a hand in there underneath the arms of McCracken. And it will be an opportunity from that Roberts mistake for the rugby union convert, the man who played 7 tests for the All Blacks, Frano Botica. He moved to the Wigan club, and in that English season just gone by, an incredible 324 points.
He's a goal kicker in Matthew Ridge's class, Graham, and the pressure won't bother this fellow at all. It's right within his range, and he's a consistent kicker at this distance, and it's certainly a good opportunity for New Zealand to gain first blood.
He's about 37, 38 metres out from the Australian line. Just a little bit off centre. Botica eyeing off 2 points. strikes it pretty well. Is it coming round enough? It's not. So opportunities have gone missing for both sides. Paul Hoff gets away. It was left open up the middle for Hoff. Now Lewis out wide. Lewis allowed to run. Ettinghausen. Good cover defence from New Zealand. Roberts. The work to come from the back row. Langer. Searching ball out. Mistake. Luckily, Dale Shearer goes back to check for that one. Dangerous passing from Australia. Much more solid as Bob Lidner. Trying to keep their cool now in the danger zone. Steve Walters with a scurry up the middle. Lonergan missed him. Put down heavily by Kemp. Quick hands. Lonergan getting it to Botica. I just wonder if Lonergan is okay. It was a pretty easy tackle that he missed on Steve Walters.
Yeah, I think it might be an idea if someone went out from the New Zealand side. Someone, the runner went out, brought it to the referee's attention, got him off, put him in the cut bin for 10 minutes, get him fixed up, give him a rest, put one of the fresh players out, then send him back out. With the cut bin, there is the opportunity to do that, and I think it'd be a good idea.
Brent Todd gets over the advantage line strongly, as did Peter Brown. Freeman linking with Kemp. The kick. Kick and chase. Hoff coming across. He beats them again. Great tackle from Freeman. Electric pace here at Olympic Park. Both sides keen to give this ball plenty of air. Roberts.
At this stage, Graham, New Zealand's working very well out of the marker position. Australia is having trouble getting out of their own half because New Zealand's working well out of the mark area, forcing errors such as that.
Bustling defence from the Kiwis, and Australia with plenty on their mind. Lewis with a super reverse pass to Hoff. Not such a good kick, and it travels sweetly down to Botica. Langer's there. Good tackle from the Australian halfback. Williams. A stuttering run brought to an end by Clyde and also Lidner. Quickly to his feet. Todd again. More work for the Canberra front rower. Roach finished him off with a bit of a shoulder charge. Short hands from Brown. A massive hit on Nikau that clears the ball. Shearer. Shearer and Botica. Shearer kicking. Oh, geez, it was nearly a sensational try. Another mistake from New Zealand. That ball travelled forward. Now Lewis involved. They didn't like the tackle of Lewis on McCracken, but Shearer really showed his skill. This is nearly blown up here, but what a remarkable try it nearly was. New Zealand did well to cover. Now John Holdsworth looks back over as Lewis stands his ground, and Todd and the Kiwis look daggers just as well. Holdsworth will go back to force the scrum. Only 5 metres out from the New Zealand line, it will be an Australian feed. Langer. Dangerous times for New Zealand. Lewis. Langer trying to create the extra man. Good defence from Watson. He tries to hold him down. Now Clyde, the big lock forward, 2 metres away. New Zealand, backs to the wall, trying to hang on. Langer is smothered. They're up extra quick. Lewis to Meninga, knocked down. Australia should come back with more possession as the New Zealand fans show their anxiety sideline. Meninga bleeding from the eye. He should be ordered to the blood bin under the new rule.
There's a bit of blood out there on both sides, mate.
Meninga stepping out of one. Hoff! Hoff! Ettinghausen tried to support him, but he slipped over in back play. Lewis. Lewis leading the charge here for Roberts. They're still only 5 and 6 metres away. The defence from New Zealand has been good. Meninga. Meninga trying to crash down. But he is held up. Again, they survive. Excellent play to live again.
Well, Bailey's a worried man there, but The Kiwis have done quite well over the last passage of play. That was a strong run by Mel Meninga, that.
On the Cadbury Borough replay, Meninga gets across the line, but he can't get it down. Look at the black and white jumpers.
They've done well there, mate. They've withstood that pressure. Now they've got to keep a cool head. No errors. That is the key there. It's a crucial part of the game.
We're in Melbourne. We're in Australian rules territory, Lowie. But already, we're seeing a great test match open up.
This is carrying straight on from the recent State of Origin series. The players out there are providing this crowd with what rugby league wants. They're also providing New Zealand with what they want.
Martin Bella, fired up in the Australian engine room, but the defence from New Zealand has been excellent. The Australians have the penalties 3-2. But Duane Mann is leading the way amongst the forwards for New Zealand. He's already made 9 tackles. He gets the restart now for Jason Williams, who slips. There has been quite a deal of rain in the last month in Melbourne. And the curators, the ground staff here, have done a marvellous job to have this Olympic Park ground in such a condition. Kemp. Maybe not the territory where New Zealand really do want to try and spread this ball. Much better from the experienced captain. He wants to get out of here.
Well, that's good tactics by Garrett. New Zealand were under pressure then. That's what they needed, and they followed it up with a very good chase.
Hoff has already been dangerous. Upended, well, very close to a spear tackle. John Holdsworth, the referee, might have thought about it. But the Kiwis really are showing their mettle. Another penalty against Todd this time.
You know, New Zealand's got to get their act a little bit together with these penalties. Gary's got to lay down the law to his players there.
Now the Cadbury Morrow replay. This is the tackle on Hoff. Now the spear tackle rule says that head and shoulders shouldn't be put into the turf like that. But Hoff is okay, and the Australians say thanks to another penalty. Overall, Australia has had possession for some 36 tackles. New Zealand 23. Roach head down. This is a real test match. Plenty of fire. New Zealand standing up to the Australians. Clive going short blindside. Walters looks to the open. Here's the call from Langer and Lewis. The Queensland combination. Back inside as Roberts. Steve Walters cuts a man out. Meninga gives it away to Jason Williams. He's still travelling to the halfway. There is no doubt about it that they are bustling the Australians into some errors.
They are. Australia's trying to settle into their normal play, and New Zealand's handling it well.
Freeman. Oh, great tackle. Marvellous play from both sides. Freeman started that, tried to sneak away down the sideline, but big Ian Roberts got across in cover and drove him over the sideline. Nikau with a good short ball to Lonergan on the Cadbury Morrow replay. Freeman trying to get away. Look out.
Dean Lonergan's answered his critics about how tough he is. He got poleaxed a while ago. He's come back. He's full of it now.
Bradley Clyde hitting it to the line. The Australians have made 4 handling errors. New Zealand just the 2. Bella. 45 metres out from their own line, Australia. It's on the last tackle. It wasn't. I misread Holdsworth's signal. He tries to urge the Kiwis back to 5 metres. Lewis under pressure. Still under pressure. Great chasing. The Australians being put off their game a little. A little bit of pressure. It's mounting. Now Hoff. Plenty of time for him to get the kick in. And he drives Botica back to his own in goal. Botica. He can't beat the tackle of Bob Lidner. Lidner was the Kangaroo named the player of the tour when they toured Great Britain and France last year. Now Blackmore goes to the other side of the field to get his first touch. Big shoulder hit from Roberts on Mann. Out to Todd. Todd showing it. Trying to get something started for Emosi Koloto. Now Todd. Another shoulder charge over the top from Roberts. No big pardons. Take no prisoners in the forwards. Kemp off the side of the boot, but he's going to get a superb bounce.
This game's a very even contest at the moment there, Graham. I think Bob would be very pleased with the way the guys are going, because I think New Zealand is coming up with the answer of everything that Australia's tried at the moment, and it's going to take a touch of brilliance from a player on either side to break this defence, because they're both cancelling one another out.
Lewis with a confident charge. The Australians come at New Zealand again. They've had the better possession territorially. They went very close to scoring through Dale Shearer. But the recovery of New Zealand has been excellent, and they have continued to force the mistakes. And the mistakes in the hands come once more. Botica stepping, but into a mile of trouble. Mann swinging arm on Duane Mann from Steve Walters. Now Todd. Todd is trying to be everywhere in attack and defence. Brown beats one, keeps his hands clear, looking for a runner. Through the arms of Koloto to Freeman. Freeman over the head of Paul Hock. Remembering the international rule, defending players must remain 10 metres away if they are in front of the kicker. Now Lidner, beating one, taken by Duane Mann. To Bella. Steve Walters to Roach. Well, Jim McGann, I know you're on the edge of your seat down there, but they really have settled down into some good defensive tactics.
They really have, Brad, and that's something that's going to tell aside from later on in the game. They were a bit panicky there in the first half, but as long as they can settle down and not get too many guys coming up out of the line too quickly, where Australia are finding some holes, then they're going to do a bit of damage out there.
Meninga tries to show his muscle. A little bit of frustration, more than midway through this first half. At this stage, the Kangaroos no doubt would have liked to have got into a handy lead.
Well, at this stage of the game, normally mistakes are penalised heavily.
Here goes Freeman, he's got support too. Watson, McCracken, great support play. The Kiwis come from deep. To his feet quickly, Freeman taking it on, kicking ahead. There's no one home, no fullback. Somebody might be in the bin here. Freeman was put down after he kicked it. Martin Bell is the culprit, but does he end up in the bin? A chance at goal, some quick thinking from the New Zealand captain. This was the break, and just watches the outside backs cite the chance here that Freeman provides. Good quick hands from Watson. Quite a combination, Watson and McCracken. The Australians recovered, but when they did, they gave away the penalty. 4-3 in favour of Australia, those penalties. And Botica, he's taken it back to the 22 as he waits for some sand. Well, the closest New Zealand have come to upsetting the Australians has been takes us back to 1985, Graham Lowe, series you know only too well.
Yeah, but that game was decided by concentration in the last couple of minutes of the game, and that's what it's all about when you're playing against Australia. New Zealand, we had that second test match. We had that game won, but concentration let us down in the last moments. But these fellows out here tonight, they're doing a good job for New Zealand. But Australia are doing as well also. Australia are trying very, very hard. Their forwards are being worked over the field, and they're having to come up with plenty of steam.
The last test win was a one-off encounter in 87, which New Zealand won. They've started well here tonight. Botica. Can he get that scoreboard working? He can. Some points at last for New Zealand. No emotion from Bob Bailey, but the Kiwis lead 2-0. There has been plenty of black and white dynamite. Some strong play amongst the forwards. Meninga. Getting it down, deep to the in goal, Watson, around the forwards, offloading to Botica, He gets away from Langer. He doesn't get away from Lewis. A little bit of confidence coming into their play. They're building New Zealand. Mann to Freeman. Todd. Some outstanding work from him amongst the four. Freeman again. Kemp. Right on their own 22. Brown. Forced towards the sideline. He just manages to stay in. Last tackle. No pressure on Kemp. But this man has created a few problems of his own hop. You need to get down there quickly and in big numbers. Stepping. Excellent chasing.
Well, that's a very good kicking game, Graham, because there's basically the whole Australian forward pack still offside at the moment.
New Zealand have had four missed tackles, the Australians three. Steve Walters has to be watched from dummy half. Twice he's got away so far. Roberts. Some hard working back rows in both sides. Walters looking to the back line. Lewis. Nikau's up there to cut him off. He stands, gets it back to Hoff. Off to the outside of Lonergan. Good tackle. The Australians searching for some answers. Langer, driving kick. Off the post. Botica. They keep it alive again to Koloto. Koloto on the fringe, where he is most dangerous. Working it away well from their danger zone, Lonergan. Plenty of courage from him already in this test match. Man to Kemp. Awful pass. It bounces up well for Nikau. But they go back near their 22. They'll be looking to kick. Freeman. Off the side of his boot. Shearer is there. Stands his ground. 42 metres out he's taken. Off. Looking for a lot of work for a fullback. Langer to Roberts. Well, Huey, do you get the feeling that the Australians just can't come up with the right answers at the moment?
They're trying everything that they can to throw what they can at New Zealand, but New Zealand is scrambling very well in defence. It's something that's a trademark of their game in recent years. And they're showing it well here again tonight. It's something that they really have to work on for the rest of the game and make sure it is consistent right through.
Don't you get tempted, Huey, to break out if somebody sneaks away?
There's a spare pair of football boots on the sideline. You never know, I could throw them on quickly.
All right, Eddinghausen. Good quick hands from the Australians. Botica. He nearly took that Indian goal and nearly was able to bring it back. He will bring it back to the 22. Excellent tackle from Eddinghausen. Oh, this match is superb at the moment. Some great defence and some good open play from both sides.
It's the time of the game that it's quite easy for the match to turn, Graham. And just a nice cool heads, carry on the way they're going, but with the wrong end of the ground, but they're not coming up with any errors themselves and they're forcing Australia into plenty. But it is a danger time in the game. I think they should get down the other end as quickly as possible.
McCracken nearly got away. Good tackle. It needed to be from Roberts. Gary Freeman heard you, Lowy, as he puts it behind Eddinghausen. But he has kicked to an open wing. Now they get down there. They force him across field. They haven't kept their line. Great chasing tackle from Dave Watson. The Australians are having to work extra hard. Clyde right in midfield. Langer. Lewis. Lewis out to Hoff. Off chase, put down by Nikau. The enthusiasm very evident. Anytime anybody looks like breaking the line, there are two and three across in cover.
The key to New Zealand's defence at the moment is excellent chasing from the first marker. They're chasing and putting all sorts of pressure on. Excellent work.
Roach with a fumble. Bella with a fumble. New Zealand have it.
Again, it's from that first marker, Graham.
There is plenty of heat in the kitchen, and the Australians are feeling it. Watson. Watson to McCracken. Power of the young man. And a great ball away. Blackmore wrestled to the ground. Lindner and Roberts over there. It is tit for tat here at Olympic Park. And now it is tit for tat in the penalty stakes. Inside the 5 metres, the Australians. Freeman with a decision. Maybe too far out for Botica. They go sideline.
Yeah, but it's relieving a bit of pressure. And one thing's evident at this stage, Graham. A lot of these fellas in the New Zealand side were unknown to the Australian, but their names are certainly well known now. So are the bottom of their boots, because they're running all over them.
Now Lonergan. Both sides looking for somebody to break. Watson beautifully creates the extra man for Botica. Out wide, New Zealand possessed plenty of pace and plenty of willing workers up the middle like Todd. Duane Mann for a run. The Australians stand back and allow him to come to the 22. He flicks it out the back. Brown, beautiful step. Freeman. Freeman looking for a try. Koloto knocks on. Oh, great chance for New Zealand. And the Australians were stretched to the limit. Meninga, the captain, trying to lift his side because he knows they are under enormous pressure. New Zealand must be careful about the Australians on counter-attack. Quick play of the balls as Lindner lifts the pace to get it 32 metres out. And another quick play of the ball. Koloto couldn't get back in time. This is where they can be dangerous. New Zealand, some of the forwards only just getting back. And the ball was stolen. The Kiwis lead 2-0. What a great opportunity at the other end.
It was, Graham, but it's unfortunate, because this is what happened, because they didn't work the marker defence properly.
You can't go to sleep against them. The Australians were in trouble, but now they come back to put on their own pressure. Steve Walters. Langer brings Shearer off the wing. Like two heavyweight champions searching each other out. Lindner from a mile back gets it to 8 metres out. Roach, Meninga up the middle. Only a couple of metres away. A thrilling first half so far. Steve Walters, try. The defence didn't stay low enough. He has been one of the danger men, Steve Walters. Australia 4, New Zealand 2, right under the black dot, and Bob Bailey can only ponder what might have been at the other end. On the Cadbury Moro replay, they got it to about 6 or 7 metres away. Meninga tried to find something up the middle, and then the defence didn't stay low on Steve Walters. He snuck out of dummy half very quickly, and he's a powerful little hooker.
There was a gap there a mile wide. Unfortunately, Australia was making great drives towards the line, and New Zealand kept their support players out wide. It was a well-taken try there by Steve Walters, and you've got to take your hat off to him. He's the one that started the momentum to gather that try, and he finished it off.
Plenty of possession for the Australians in the opposition half. They've had 21 tackles. New Zealand only thrown down the other end. But Meninga, unsuccessful with that first attempt. Now from right in front. No mistake. And the Australian fans here in Olympic Park celebrate a lead of 6 points to 2. But Meninga knows as he walks back over halfway that he has a real test match on his hands. Hope you're enjoying all the action, live and exclusive on 3. The New Zealand bench with plenty to think about. But they have shown plenty of toughness in this international arena. They've had a couple of good opportunities. When you get down there, you've really got to make it count.
That's right, and New Zealand didn't, but You know, they've played well. They've been able to withstand the brilliance of Australia so far. That was brute force that got them that try. Brute force and slackness on defence at the other end of the ground. New Zealand can come back into this game. They can strike back immediately. There's not a lot of time left in this first half, but they can strike back. They've just got to keep forcing those errors.
Steve Walters, busy in the midfield. Quick play, the ball back for Lewis, which gives him time to drive this kick towards the sideline. One bounce, only two bounces. All of a sudden, the Australian game comes together. And this will be a vital period now for New Zealand. Great kick from Lewis.
Well, he's a fine player. And at this stage, it's a battle of nerves because Wally is the one that's dictated the play there. And I think Gary Freeman has done a great job for New Zealand so far. He's got to show the cool head, keep New Zealand at their plan, and come up with the counter.
Now, Roach has been ordered to that blood bin. And for Australia, Gillespie is out there in 17.
They're certainly not losing anything there. That's another tough player they brought on. And he will actually inject plenty more enthusiasm into this game.
Roach, off to have maybe a couple of stitches. As Gillespie, he is known as the hitman in Australian Rugby League. A terrific defender. Koloto runs it away from the line. McCracken, keen for another touch of the ball. And a vital 10 or 12 metres as he got down that short blind side. Freeman with a long searching ball to Kemp. Kemp showed the dummy, but Langer didn't take it. Brown, stepping, keeping his hands clear. Last tackle against New Zealand. Kemp with the kick, looking for the sideline, trying to get it away from Hock. Ball sits up nicely for him though. And another good tackle from Watson. He's been impressive in the centres along with McCracken. Eddinghausen looking for a gap. There's none there as he finishes up on halfway. Langer calling for a switch of play. But the defence had moved up quickly. Hop into the line. You think the pace of the game may have a big say on it? The Australians or the New Zealanders? Who would you rate the fittest?
Well, undoubtedly the Australians would be the fitter, and it is starting to tell on the likes of Koloto, but I'm very, very impressed with Dean Lonergan. Like, he got bashed in the first couple of minutes there, and he's come back strong. He's leading New Zealand. He's encouraging them. He's inspiring them. And he's been well supported, I think, by the centres out there, McCracken and Watson. They're having fine games.
The New Zealanders know that they need to be the next scorers. They don't want to give any extra advantage to the Australians. Nothing in this test match, really. Freeman, with confidence as they go wide inside their own 22. Lonergan standing wide amongst the centres. Well, one-hander back to Jason Williams. He hasn't had too many good opportunities. Good step from Duane Mann. Here's the chance. Well, they went back infield. They seemed to have numbers out on the right, but they took the wrong option.
Well, that's heartbreaking, that was, Graham, because they did have numbers and a try was on, I feel.
They might have been inside their own 22, but they had two or three men left over. Now, they get it back to Williams, but Lewis is there. Plenty of good ball control, though.
This is rugby league.
Freeman. Big defence from the Australians. It was Gillespie and Meninga. What a duo to run into. Kemp, a little bit of a chip, something different, a little bit of variety. But that is superbly read. Clyde tidied it up. Now Hoff puts it down. Nikau and Roberts, shoulder to shoulder. Roberts gets back. Six more tackles. Gary Freeman will be urging his side on, looking for a try here. Getting close to the break at halftime. Bella, he's hammered to the ground.
Kiwis need a quick turnover here. If they can force an error, Australia a bunch, you can throw a blanket over the lot of them. New Zealand can gain the ball here. They can sneak in just before half time.
Gillespie trying to wrestle to his feet. Langer, little dummy. Gets it back to Steve Walters. Now to Gillespie straightening.
And he will play it nearly where he did just a moment ago. Lewis. Sailing over the head of Botica. To the in goal. He will have a tough time as he meets his Australian line. But he confidently took it to Meninga, who slows him to the ground. Williams. They are pushed back, New Zealand, 10 metres out from their own line. Lindner there in defence. Lewis went missing over the top. It is 6-2 to the Australians. Todd. Letting nobody down in this New Zealand side, but they have only one more tackle now as Mann. The error is forced from him from dummy half, and it is a handover on the last. Trouble here for New Zealand. The call is to go wide. Bradley Clyde trying to straighten things up. Right in midfield, outside the 22. Lindner. Back for Shearer. To Clyde. To Steve Wallace. To Lewis. Great quick hands. John slips. The defence has held its line well. Now they look for some work from Bella. An awkward pass that falls well now for Meninga. Meninga throws Freeman away. Gets it back to Eddinghausen. Botica tries to pick it up. Langer has it, but there is a knock-on.
A couple of minutes of trouble here for New Zealand at the moment. I think the New Zealand forwards are tiring badly, and they were lucky to get away with this.
The scrum to go down 9 metres out. I think time has just about gone into overtime in this first half. McCracken. Jarrod McCracken making his test debut tonight against Australia. He's 21 years of age. Now Botica. Williams got tripped up. It was Watson who tried to bring him inside, I should say. And finally the siren goes. Well, the appetites have really been whetted. Australia lead 6-2 here at Olympic Park, but they know that they have a test match on their hands. New Zealand have had a couple of chances and they've nearly crossed the line. Marvellous test match opening up here. Hope you're enjoying it. Live on 3 back in New Zealand, we will return with Clint Brown, Hugh McGann and Graham Lowe and their thoughts on the first 40 right after this.
Good evening. Updating 3 National News, the government is expected to lift taxes on alcohol and tobacco in the upcoming budget. In a Nightline political poll, Jenny Shipley tops the list as the most preferred Prime Minister. And in the league test played tonight, the result a dramatic... Nightline returns tomorrow night.
Peanut Moro, creamy caramel, roasted peanuts, Cadbury dairy milk chocolate.
Get milk on can show you how.
A mate of mine used to keep all his savings in a tin. So I told him, why not open a key saver with Postbank and gather interest instead of dust? You get this flash-looking book and your interest is calculated daily. And if you open one now, you could win $500 a month for a whole year. Well, he opened KeySaver and he reckons he'll win. So you know what he's given me?
Postbank. Simply banking.
To 3 Sport Live from Melbourne Olympic Park. Half time here in the big ball game, and it's the local Maori tribe putting on their display to Mana at the moment. Half time comments from Hugh McGann. Huey, your impressions of the first 20 minutes?
I thought New Zealand have taken the game to Australia. That's what they had to do. They had to go forward, meet them, and that's exactly the tactics they've employed. As far as their attack goes, that surprised a lot of people. The Australians themselves by throwing the ball out wide in their own 22. I wouldn't have expected it, and Australia haven't expected it, but it's worked well for them so far.
What about in the last 20 minutes in that first half? Signs of tiredness creeping into both sets of forwards?
Into both sets, but more so in New Zealand. They haven't had the state of origin build-up that the Australians have had, and it's starting to show on them. But if they get their nose in front, they'll go the rest of the game on their heart alone.
OK, Graham Lowe, reserves, how important are they going to be in this game in the second half?
Well, they're going to play a major factor, and that's where Australia does have a definite advantage with their reserve lineup. But, you know, at this stage, the New Zealand backs, in my opinion, are coming out on top of the Australian backs.
Why is that?
Well, I think just their speed, their enterprise, the manner in which they're playing. Bob's got them playing a good style of football, but I'm a little worried about, the forwards there. I think Mossy Koloto is just feeling the pinch a little bit. I hope that this 10-minute break will do him the world of good, because we need a good 10 minutes, 15 minutes out of him now if Bob's going to put him back at all, because we need his damaging runs now. He's really been tiring a lot in the last 5 or 10 minutes, but by and large, they are playing very, very well, I think.
If anyone comes off the Kiwi reserve bench, who would you put on in the first 20 minutes, perhaps in that second spell? Guys like George Mann, Clayton, Brent?
Yeah, well, I think George Mann is a robust type of player, and he could certainly do some damage out there. But New Zealand is making inroads at the moment by using their smart backs. I'd keep the forwards off as long as possible. I'd give Koloto probably another 10 minutes. And then the first player I'd put on, I think, would be Clayton Friend.
OK, we'll be checking out the halftime comments. And also coming up after the match, of course, it's the UBIX MVP. $2,000 for the most impressive player from the Kiwi comments. On the Kiwi bench. What about the kicking game? Is that going to be important in the second spell too, Hugh?
That's going to be very, very important for New Zealand. They have to employ the same tactics as what Australia are using at the moment. You're doing the hard yards up the front with their forward pack, Wally Lewis and Alan Langer, and Hopper getting in there and pinning New Zealand back in their own 22. That's what New Zealand have to do if they want to get away with the win tonight.
Experts' comments tonight from former Kiwi captain Hugh McGann and former Kiwi coach Graham Lowe. Let's look back at the highlights of the first 40 minutes of the Cadbury-Morrow Ultimate Test.
Now, this is the incident of Lonergan putting his head in the wrong position. He put his head right in front of Roach, and he took a shoulder and a forearm, and he ended up in Disneyland. Short hands from Brown. A massive hit on Nikau that clears the ball. Shearer and Botica. Shearer kicking. Oh, geez, it was nearly a sensational try. Now the Cadbury-Morrow replay. This is the tackle on Hoff. Now the spear tackle rule says that head and shoulders shouldn't be put into the turf like that. It started well here tonight. Botica. Can he get that scoreboard working? He can. He flicks it out the back. Brown. Beautiful step, Freeman! Freeman looking for a try, Koloto knocks on. A thrilling first half so far. Steve Wallace, try!
There was a gap there a mile wide. Unfortunately, Australia was making great drives towards the line, and New Zealand kept their support players out wide.
So it's Australia 6-2 in front after the first 40 minutes, and it's going to be an intriguing second 40 minutes to see who lines up as the UBIX MVP to get that $2,000 worth of promotional contracts. Quickly, Hugh McGann, before we go to the break and get set for the second half, that turning point when the Kiwis missed that try or that chance for the try, just how crucial could that be in this game?
Oh, it'd be costly for them at this stage. You know, they're only 4 points behind. If they had got that try, that would have been 4 points in front at the moment. It may be costly for them later on in the game, but I'm sure by the time the game gets going again, they'll be right back into it. They need to get back in early.
Okay, well, let's go back to the break, and we'll be back with live action coming up in just a moment as we continue with our exclusive coverage here on 3 Sport. Great to have you with us as we get set for a big winter of rugby league.
...6.30 Saturday on 3.
I hope you're doing this at home.
It's a multicultural experience.
Teriyaki, Terry Wogan, Harry Carey, Harry Seacombe.
It's a moment of naked revelation.
Is that right? You wanted to be a pickup?
Yes, but it was only a passing fancy.
It's play acting at its very worst.
Well, I wouldn't want to get my left booby.
It's Bruce Forsyth's all-new generation game.
Give me the keys to your car and I'll poke it for you.
Bigger and better than ever. 6.30 Saturday before the family night of the movies on TV3.
Proud to be sponsors of Rugby League in New Zealand. CRC 556. CRC 556. CRC 556. CRC gets New Zealand going. Photocopiers are more reliable because the UBIX service program keeps wear and tear in check after check, year after year. So, better get a UBIX? You bet. The action is hotter. The stakes are higher. The effects are twice as dangerous.
Gotcha.
FX2, the deadly art of illusion. See it at a theater near you.
Kick for victory! The Caltex Rugby World Cup prize game with over 300,000 prizes up for grabs.
We've got thousands of instant prizes. It's three fabulous all-black cars by Ford, plus the grand prize draw of 10 fantastic free trips to the World Cup.
It's easy to win. Every time you buy a Coke Cadbury Moro or packet of Bluebird chips from Caltex, you'll get a kick for victory, scratch and win game card. So get on down to Caltex to be a winner.
Not what goes into the Technics MIDI systems, it's what comes out.
New Cadbury Peanut Moro, creamy caramel, roasted peanuts, Cadbury Dairy Milk Chocolate.
Welcome back to the great game, live and exclusive on 3 Sport in Melbourne here at Olympic Park. And joining us on the sideline now, one of the all-time greats of Australian Rugby League, the Parramatta man, Peter Sterling. Peter, your impressions of that first 40 minutes?
Well, I think everybody at the ground here, I was very impressed by both teams' performance. Certainly New Zealand in the first 20 minutes, I thought, had the better of the play. Allowed what I suppose they'd consider a soft try from Steve Wallace under the post. but it's really set up in the second half, only 4 points between the teams and anybody's game at the moment.
The atmosphere here in Melbourne is a good move to bring the game down here.
Well, you know, you have a look around here, it has to be successful. We've got a capacity crowd, a very vocal crowd, and I know that everybody here is enjoying it. Plenty of support for both teams.
The big cheer at the moment is for Jeff Fenwick. If we just get a shot of Jeff Fenwick, there he is, the man of the moment in Australian sport, the guy who was robbed of victory in that big boxing counter. There hasn't been too much bip out there in the forwards in the first half. Good sign for the second.
Well, I think so. You know, very physical, and that's the way test matches should be played. And what a marvellous atmosphere, as you say. A guy like Jeff Fenwick, he loves the game. He's out here supporting, and, you know, everybody's having a tremendous night. A good second half coming up.
Jeff Fenwick at the moment is just talking to his fans here in Melbourne. Of course, that has been the big talking point over the last few weeks here in Aussie.
Tonight's game, how's it going?
Well, I think it's been a great game. New Zealand have shocked us all, really. They're putting up a great fight, and hopefully I'll do the same in the second half and entertain all the crowd.
Thank you very much, Jeffrey. Ladies and gentlemen, two great Australians, Jeffrey Fenwick and Ian Murray.
Okay, Jeffrey Fenwick there, of course. Johnny Lewis, the man he's involved with training, him is involved with training the Australian League team. And Peter, now you and Hugh McGann, of course, have played against each other quite a few times. How do you think it's going to go out there for this next 40 minutes? You two have a battle here and sort it out between the two of us, okay?
Yeah, great, thanks for it. Well, Hughie's run over me plenty of times, I know that. I must admit, I've been particularly impressed with Gary Freeman. I think if New Zealand were to have played well, he had to lead the way, the most experienced player in the side, and I think he's been inspirational. Probably needs to be again for this next 40 minutes.
Yeah, you call it right there, Peter. He has to take the game to Australia. He showed in the first half that he's confident taking the ball forward. He's got to look for the hole for his outside backs. He's done that so far, but as you said, he's got to continue that in the second half.
And one thing they have done particularly well is to keep Wally Lewis in check. Again, that's an area they must keep up with.
Yeah, it has come into vogue in the first half. The outside backs are getting up very quick, trying to cut that ball off. They've been lucky not to be pinged there a couple of times because they really were offside, but if it's working well for them at the moment, why change their plan?
Okay, both these guys have got their golden boots. The players are coming out now, and who do you think is going to get the golden boot out there tonight?
Well, the best player on the field so far to me has been Dave Watson, the centre. He's had an absolutely outstanding game, and a player that I didn't know a lot of, but I know of him now.
All right, well, watch out for that later on tonight. Thanks for talking to us, Peter Stirling.
Thanks very much.
And, of course, more expert comments coming up from Hugh McGann. Just about set now for the second half. Let's go back to Graham Hughes and Graham Lowe.
Thank you, Clint. Now thanks to Peter Stirling, who evens the score up a little bit here. Lowey, now it's only used three Kiwis against us, two Australians.
Yeah, well, it's not really even because we normally only need one Kiwi.
Now it goes back to 13 against 13. No changes in the New Zealand side from half-time. Reminder that David Gillespie replaced Steve Roach prior to the half-time break for the Australians. He is still out there in that lineup. And we get underway. 40 minutes remaining. The Australians leading 6-2. The pitch is coming to you on 3Sport from the 7 Network here in Australia. And talking of 7, the number 7 for New Zealand, Gary Freeman, taken by the number 7 from Australia, Alan Langer. Big hit from Meninga. A big hit on Koloto, a man who I think has to produce some more running for New Zealand.
Certainly does, Graham, on the fringes of the ruck where the opportunities have been created and encouraged by Gary Freeman. He's got to get involved, and he's certainly done the first couple of rucks up there.
Bob Bailey getting all wired up on the bench as Hoff goes back to the in goal. Good chasing, Freeman gets him. He nails him only 6 metres away. The Australians back to their line. The Kiwis looking for a super quick start from the break.
Again, that first marker play is working very, very effectively.
Eddinghausen, crunched by three defenders. The Australians a little bit bunched. Gillespie hit and put down by Mann Koloto. Now it's Shearer off his wing, trying to take the pressure off his forwards, trying to give them an extra rest. Last tackle. Can they get down on the kicker? Can they put him off? Lewis gets the kick in. Bad bounce, trapped by Blackmore. And Blackmore's taken by Shearer and Langer. overall possession in that first half. Australia had it for 81 tackles. New Zealand, 69. And as far as the opposition half is concerned with possession, New Zealand just the 12 tackles. Australia, a massive count of 30. Duane Mann. New Zealand just short of halfway. Back for the kick. And that will force the ball up the side of the boot. Back to 45 metres out from the New Zealand line, the scrum to back. Here's Clint Brown with Bob Bailey.
Kiwi coach Bob Bailey, your message to the team in the second spell?
Well, I just said that our double markers weren't working the first half and we cost us a try. So we missed out on once with our double markers, and that's what's cost us the point so far.
Are you going to work the reserve bench in the second spell?
Yeah, I certainly am. I'm waiting for the right opportunity to see what's happening here in the second half before I do that.
Okay, coach, thanks for talking to us, mate.
You can certainly feel the tenseness in the voice of Bob Bailey as the Australians launch a raid. Meninga breaks away, grabbed by McCracken. Shearer bamboozles the defence. Down the touchline. Lewis, what a try! Cover. It looked like an Australian try. Gary Freeman chased. Lewis can't believe the decision. He stares at Holdsworth on the Cadbury Morrow replay. Meninga kept it alive to Shearer. Blackmore didn't know where he was. He got away. Lewis inside. Freeman, look at the determination. Did he hold him up? Lewis trying to get it down. Well, that didn't clearly tell the story, but Holdsworth was perfectly placed.
I think he held him up, and it was a late movement that Wally did try and pull the ball down. And I think the referee made the right decision. I also think it was a great piece of work by Gary Freeman. He's doing an outstanding job for New Zealand at the moment.
The Kiwis working it away. They were forced to make 93 tackles in the first half. Todd led the way with a great 17. Mann with 15. Nikau 11. Koloto 9. They were the tops. The Australians made 69. Roberts with 11. Clyde, Walters and Linda with 8 each. Now it's Hoff. Hoff bringing it back. The kick downfield from Kempy was shouldered by Steve Walters. No call on the play. Clayton Friend, warming up sideline for New Zealand. You heard it from Bob Bailey that he's going to work the bench. Chris Johns, he has Eddinghausen, the man they call E.T. Over the top, Meninga couldn't get it. Knocked back by Nikau. Again they get back. Well, the Australians trying to find top gear, Lowing.
They are, no, they've gone away from trying to play New Zealand down the middle. They're trying to play New Zealand's game now out wide. And it is proving effective, especially on these first turnovers. That's when the openings are there, when both sides are first receiving the ball. The initial tackles are when it's on the other side of the field.
McCracken. He and Watson have done well deep in their own 22s on a number of occasions. Watson, great ball. Todd takes it brilliantly. Looking for Williams. In and away, he beats. No, he doesn't. Eddinghausen only just managed to grab a boot.
He can play.
The Kiwis on the breakaway. The Freeman is trapped on halfway. It'll be a handover. So there was a desperate tackle by Eddinghausen that could have meant the difference. They were away, New Zealand. But now they have to handle some more pressure from Australia. Steve Walters. He finds Clyde up the middle. The big man's got support. Gillespie chased. Put down. It's Freeman again who got there. Freeman has never beaten. And I think he knew he had to give the penalty away. His team was in trouble. He thought the try could have been on the end of that. And he was trying to give his team time to get back onside. But this professional foul will mean that he will be in the bin for 10. Holdsworth knew what was on. He had no hesitation. So they're without their skipper. And the Australians, instead of a chance at four or six, will have a look in at two as Freeman leaves the field. Now he's making a walk to the bench. The officials will ask him to leave the ground completely. Bob Bailey knows that he can't sit sideline.
That's come about, Graham, because Australia has started New Zealand's type of play and spinning the ball wide quickly on the first plays. And what that is doing is opening up the centre.
Freeman to the tunnel. We will see the New Zealand captain in 10 minutes. But now it's the Australian captain. 50% record. You would call this a gift. From right in front, 12 metres out. 50 points against New Zealand in his career. He makes it 52. They get a little bit of a comfort zone, the Australians. But not a great deal. It is 8-2.
I think there must be a lot of pressure on Bob at the moment because it's a lonely part of the game now. It's a very, very lonely part of the game for a coach because he has players sitting on the sideline. He's lost his captain, lost his halfback. What should he do? Should he get Friend on now and bring on somebody else or what?
Well, he's down to 12 men. Does he move Watson to half and Nikau out amongst the centres?
Well, that's probably what he'll have to do, but, you know, I think the temptation still there to put Clayton on and get a proper halfback in there and bring someone off the field, further out off the field.
Well, Huey, it's starting to become something what was different in the first 40 minutes. New Zealand were so good in the first 20, but the Australians have come out racing since the break.
I think Bob Fulton's really got stuck into them there at halftime. They've come out with a new lease of life, throwing the ball around like New Zealand were in the first half, and it's working well for them. New Zealand have to get themselves back on track again. It's unfortunate Gary's gone off at this stage, but this is where the likes of Brent, Todd, and Tony Kemp, the senior players in this team, really have to take over.
Well, it's still the Kiwi 12 throwing themselves at the Australians, trying to force an error and a chance down in the Australian 22. Steve Walters to Langer up the middle. Shearer, great tackle. What a great hit from McCracken to stop that. The pass is thrown nowhere. Steve Walters has to go back. And the hooker will have to kick. First attempt is not a bad kick. He has been hammered after he kicked it. And we've got a touch judge coming in. Walters is down on his hands and knees. The crowd incensed at the incident. I was travelling with the flight of the ball. Walters grabs the side of his face. As Brent Todd comes over to chat to referee John Holdsworth. Steve Roach moves back to the sideline. McCracken gets called over. He went high on Walters.
He did go high. It looked like there was a bit of arm in there as well, but...
Now I just wonder as we see Botica trying to return it. He looked to finish off the tackle, McCracken.
I think he was already committed. I think he'd already started the jump. It's unfortunate that probably is the wrong part of his arm connected. But again, New Zealand need cool heads now. Brent Todd's got to get in there, show his seniority. He's got to cool these players down, and they've got to tighten up the middle of that ruck. They've only got 12 players out there, which means they have to defend closer.
Bella, he hasn't been able to dominate this New Zealand six the way he did in the State of Origin. At the moment, you might like to call it a New Zealand 5 as they defend their line with 12. The Kiwis digging deep. Australia trying to find another try. Langer ducking, weaving. No way through. Steve Walters. Meninga. Chance for Australia. Wide. They go out the Lindner back for Anninghausen short. Oh, that's marvellous stuff.
It's great defence, it's great determination, and it's total commitment to the cause. That's what that is. In normal cases, Australia would have scored a try like that.
I talked about digging deep on the Cadbury Moro replay. Just watch the cover defence. There's only 12 out there, but look at the shirts. 3, 4, 5 of them get across to bring Australia down only inches away.
And also look at the numbers that were involved, the players involved. There was so much experience on New Zealand then, up against newcomers, and the Kiwis come out on top.
They must be feeling tired. Since half-time, the Australians have lifted a worried Bob Bailey as Watson gets clear. Now they come back for more themselves. Koloto turned his back. He had to protect the ball. Now they get it wide to Botica. Blackmore goes infield. He beats the tackle of Shearer. Blackmore gets away. He might kick ahead. McCracken's there. McCracken will score to the corner. Eddinghausen, what a try. Sensational. Bob Bailey can't believe it. Olympic Park has been stung into action. They had to handle the heat. They did it. There is 12 of them. The Australians couldn't handle them out wide. Just watch the talent here. This is a spectacular try on the Cadbury Moro replay. Blackmore did so well to stay on his feet. He gets away. He hears the call. How well did he position Jarrod McCracken on debut against Australia? He gets up smiling.
Is that Jarrod McCracken's play? Is this his first test for his 15th? The New Zealand selectors must be very, very pleased with themselves. That play involved three new players. Debut games, this was. The three of them, look at the determination on his face down there. Look at the positioning of McCracken as he comes across. He is a game breaker.
Exactly what we called them prior to the kickoff. Jarrod McCracken has New Zealand back and firing. Their fans are still on their feet. Just look how determined these guys are. Botica, he is a blade of grass away from the touchline. And he has a look in here at a chance to bring everybody together. Coming round, but not enough. The New Zealanders, young men like McCracken, believing in themselves that they can do damage to the side considered the world champions. Yep. It is 8-6. And geez, I'll tell you what.
How proud of that.
The national game is well and truly alive.
How proud of those fathers back there. Jarrod McCracken, his dad is one of the great players of the past in New Zealand. Frano Botica, his dad, Nick, is a very proud man. There was a lot of pressure on him when Frano shifted to rugby league. They must be extremely pleased.
When he took off for that try, it was just like a flying handsome New Zealand jet. The carrier, of course, that TV3 Sport chooses to fly, and our thanks for their great support in helping us with this test series against Australia. Watson. Well, there'll be some anxious people back in New Zealand. People like the former test star of the 60s, Gary Phillips. He was returned home. He has suffered some ill health in the past few months. And all his great friends here in Australia send a cheerio to you, Gary. Hope you're enjoying this telecast, live and exclusive on 3 Sport. Ledner. The Australians, kangaroo tourists of 1990 through Great Britain, they lost the first test at Wembley. They were tested out. The international game is alive. The bench comes alive. Freeman keen to get back out there. Sensing a win. Sensing a big upset. Langer is making a return to the test number 7 tonight, winning back his jumper from Stewart. Bella, he was dropped after the Wembley test, and now he has been Clayton, Friend, and also Freeman. They might end up partners in crime back out on this paddock. 15 minutes gone. Botica puts it down. We check the clock now as Freeman just waits for a few seconds. The skipper's anxious to get back. Now this simple mistake. Botica just had a quick look, took his eyes off the ball. Freeman has got about 20 seconds remaining. Can they hang on again? Wait for the skipper to get back. Meninga! The Australians have made 10 handling errors. New Zealand only 6. A thrilling test match here at Olympic Park in Melbourne. Kemp goes to the bench. Whilst the Australians go to the 22. Inside the 22. It's midfield, 17 metres away. Roach. Roach is back out there with a big charge. 10 metres away. They switch to the backs. Meninga extra man, Johns. Johns looking out wide. He can't get it out. Again, it's great defence. Last tackle. They only have to hang on for one more. Langer's going to test them with a bomb. Shearer knocked back. And it's Todd, I think, who comes up with it. They wipe the sweat from the brow.
Tony Kemp sitting there, he's done a great job for New Zealand. There was a lot of pressure on him in that position. I think he's done a fine job. But I also think that Bob Bailey's made a great change there in getting Clayton Friend on. Clayton Friend, Gary Freeman together now, both good attacking players, both aggressive chasing defenders. It's just what New Zealand needs.
Well, Huey, I know you must be doing a pretty tough sideline. What's the key from here for you?
Well, here, I see the move that Bob Bailey has made in bringing on Clayton Friend is a masterstroke. With him and Gary Freeman there, it gives them a lot more options in their attack, and they're starting to prove they're getting on top of Australia with the ball. A great move by Bob.
Well, here's Freeman with a little chip. Now, it might be Captain... Mal Meninga can't believe this. He's been given 10 minutes in the bin, and I don't think he should have been. If we get a replay, it might show. Now, the defence does not have to step move away from his ground. He is entitled to turn his back, Lowy, I think.
Yeah, that was a very, very unfair call on Mel, but tough luck.
They're down to 12. I love your sense of unbiasedness, Lowy.
This is a test match, mate.
It is really a test match. It is a great test. Unfortunately, the Kiwis run it over the sideline. And it is the Cadbury Moro ultimate test as the Australian captain goes back to the bin. So both skippers have had a stint away from their lineups.
Yeah, well, I'd say that there's a lot of pressure on Bob Fulton at the moment. You know, Australia's coming to this game hot favourites. Well, it's not won or lost by either side by a long stretch of the imagination yet. But the Kiwis have proved their doubters that they have been able to come up with the goods. As I said before, the New Zealand selectors must be sitting pretty smug at the moment because they have made some brave decisions. The players that they've put in have come up trumps. They're doing a very, very good job for New Zealand.
It shows these players believe in themselves.
It also shows that New Zealand's got a damn sight more depth than a lot of people give them a lot of, you know, credit for.
Botica. The crowd has been roaring from the start of this match. Botica just pummeled to the ground. The Australian selectors high in the stands. They're like the ones with the worries.
Look like a three blind mice, don't it?
You said it, I did. Now Todd. He gets it back for Friend. The former North Sydney halfback here in Australia. Loves nothing better than to take on the Australians. Lonergan. Here goes McCracken again. Looking for support. Stepping. Oh, he seemed to cop an elbow there from Shearer. It looked to be high. Look at the numbers for New Zealand. Freeman kicking. Langer's there. Freeman gets it. No, he doesn't. We're just sitting above that Australian panel of selectors there who are pointing at their team in trouble. Freeman went so close and Langer saved the situation.
Good halfback confrontation. There's desperation out there with a big D.
Well, some critics had this match touted as the Australians at odds on and giving away 15 and 16 point start. That has all gone out the window, and the Aussie bench is looking grim.
That I think, Graham, is that one of the dangers at the moment that New Zealand has to face. The replacements that Australia can bring on are very, very good.
Well, there's trouble here. Nikau, keeping it alive. A very quick handover for New Zealand. Freeman, Todd, there's a chance. Brown, straightening. Botica, beautiful hands. Blackmore beats Shearer again.
this place has exploded. The young men are showing the experienced champions of the rugby league world what it is all about out wide. Australia are now in real trouble. Bob Bailey, if only he would probably be feeling the siren could go right now. On the Cadbury Moro replay, just look at the way they take out the defensive line. Brown tried to bring the defence in. Now the pickup from Botica was so sweet. And Blackmore is having a field day against Dale Shearer. He improves the situation and does a victory dance.
That's what confidence is. That's great skill there by Frano Botica. This fellow Blackmore, he's got a lot of Tony Iro about him. He's a very, very good young player. And how confident is that? He's an extremely good player. And again, another one that the selector should be very proud of.
I just wonder about this back line now, when you think you can go back and grab somebody like the Iro brothers into it. Now, this is the incident when the Australians lost the ball. Word has it that Bobby Lidner may have broken his leg again. He has missed most of the Winfield Cup season in Australia with a broken leg. And apparently the fear is that it has gone again.
It's a very, very sad blow for Bob, and it is a big blow for Australia, but Bob in particular, you know, he's been one of Australia's best players. It's a sad blow to see any player to leave the field like that, and I just hope that it's not a broken leg for his sake, because he's a true great sportsman.
Blackmore, what a chance for New Zealand now. Botica, can he add a valuable two? This is vital. You bet. You bet.
This is called taking candy from kids.
Not just yet. It is 12-8.
Hey, 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 hey. It's money in the bank at the moment, mate. I'm telling you. Look at those blokes there. They're not happy. They're concentrating. They know that all they've got to do is keep maintaining this pressure. I can feel your heart beating here. Look, you're trying to be a Kiwi at the moment, but your heart's nearly bumping out because you are worried.
Wally Lewis with the restart. It's 12 points to 8. As I drag Lowy back to his seat.
This is what Manly's going to do to your mob. What are they called, the Bulldogs or the Poodles or whatever they are on Sunday?
I'll speak to you Monday about that one. Now George Mann has got out there. Langer trying to work in the front line of defence. Clayton Friend gets out of there. Lonergan, McCracken, what a test to boo. This man is making his mark in no uncertain fashion. Now the word apparently from the Australian camp is that Bobby Lidner has definitely broken that leg again. Unbelievably bad news for a champion footballer.
It's very bad news, and I'm sure all rugby league supporters in New Zealand would be very sorry for the fellow as well.
This side is standing 10 foot tall. They say Paul Hoff is about 6'7" or 6'8". Well, everyone in this New Zealand side is up to him. Now Wallace to Clyde. George Mann has replaced Peter Brown in the New Zealand lineup. Shearer, a couple of glaring defensive mistakes from him, and the Kiwis have been in for two tries.
Again, another good move by Bob Bailey. I think it's a fine move by Bob. Last year, I felt that he didn't use his reserves when he could have at the right time. He was under a lot of pressure last year. I think that he's come through extremely well the way he's prepared the side before the game. Even though we don't know the outcome yet, he is doing everything right. And he's inspired the players, and they're carrying out his inspiration.
Forget about whatever which way this result turns. This is going to be written about for a long time to come. This is one of the great test matches. Tony Kemp waiting anxiously. He is really putting some work on that gum. He wants to hear the siren. Lonergan forced towards the sideline.
Is he tough enough or what?
What a comeback from him. He was knocked senseless in the first 60 seconds. And he has played a great role in this performance.
I've got to be honest, Graham. Lonergan is one of the players that I didn't think was going to be up to this game, and I've got to eat my words. He'd be one of the first players picked from now on, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, they're making the Australians really eat their own words now. We heard from Lewis
He rated the biggest asset of New Zealand their great pride. They have shown it from the start, and now they are trying to storm home. We're on line for one of the greatest upsets in rugby league test history. Williams in a little bit of trouble. And Peter Brown, who has certainly done his job for Bob Bailey. Now, is there a penalty from this scrum? Hard to understand the ruling from that far side of the field from John Holdsworth.
He's a Yorkshireman, you wouldn't know what he's saying anyway.
Alan Langer goes back for it. George Mann goes flying over the top, gets him on the second time. The Australians looking for Lewis, the man they call the king, but his crown tonight is just slipping a little. Someone has had something to say to John Holdsworth. They get marked an extra 10 metres.
Cool heads, fellas, that's what's required now, cool heads. And Gary Freeman, I think, has been showing that he can provide that for the Kiwis.
It is Mercer and Patton who also loosen up. Bella brings it up for the Australians, his best run of the night. What an incredible statistic. Now he's lost it.
Watching those reserves warming up on the sideline there before. Well, Martin Bella making that run. He's been very, very well contained tonight, Martin Bella, because he's a very strong player and New Zealand is handling him well. As I was saying, the reserves warming up on the sideline before. It will be tempting now for Bob to make changes, but everything's going okay. I think that possibly Gary Mercer might be able to come on soon because he's a good worker in defence and try and relieve some of the pressure off the forwards. But everything is going okay at the moment.
Now, Mercer is sidelined. Meninga has got back out there for the Australians. Lewis penalised for holding the man down. I was going to say, Lowy, what a statistic. You've got New Zealand in front on the scoreboard, but overall possession in the opposition half, the Australians, 42 tackles this half, New Zealand only 17.
No, it's a credit to the courage of the Kiwis, isn't it?
What a match. What a night here in Melbourne.
What about this bloke? Fair dinkum. Someone forgot to tell Dean what pain is.
Well, somebody will have to tell him what happened in the first 40. He won't remember.
I'll tell you what, he's going to have the whole of New Zealand telling him. He's done everybody proud, and he's going to remember this light game for the rest of his life.
Koloto. Freeman wrapped up by Meninga.
Just a little bit of tig and pass going on there. I think they've got to get back to the pattern they were using before. Play to the side of the field. Stretch the Australians and then...
Look out! Clayton Friend, does he have the legs? He can't control it. He's given a try. I think Clayton Friend thought he knocked that ball on. The Australians are stunned. This could be it. The game could be gone. Bob Bailey at last smiles. He thinks they've got it. Jubilation for New Zealand. Clayton Friend. On the Cadbury Morrow replay, it started back out near halfway. A little chip and chase. Another kick from Friend. What clever skills. Now, did he knock on? There was a couple of hands there. He plants it, but he wasn't sure. He looked at the touch judge.
Well, this is going to tell. It was very difficult to tell from that angle there. I must say, from the naked eye, initially I thought he did knock on, but I don't think he... Well, I don't think he does anyway, but we'll soon tell. No, that was an Australian hand. Good call by the referee. And everybody in the crowd that's Australian that's complaining about it, tough luck.
Marvellous call from John Holdsworth. Marvellous call from John Holdsworth. That is excellent refereeing. You knew all about this guy in England. He's rated number one over there.
He is rated number one. He's refereed at Wembley. He's refereed very, very big games, club matches over in the UK. He's refereed a number of test matches.
Now, Botica, has he done it again? Yes, he has. You are witnessing some of your country's greatest sporting moments here as a slice of rugby league history comes to the Victorian state of Australia. It's Olympic Park in Melbourne, and the upset looks as though it's well and truly cemented. What a night for New Zealand Rugby League. What a night for New Zealand. It's all about pride, this game. It's about skill and toughness. They have all been there in abundant qualities in this New Zealand side. They have been driven by a man called Gary Freeman, who was dropped to reserve grade for his club side in Australia, Balmain. Not good enough to play in first grade. What a star tonight.
He's answered everybody's. New Zealand needed him tonight, and he's responded. He's just played a magnificent game, Gary.
Handling problems for Eddinghausen. The Australians looking for a miracle. They're looking for someone who normally gets changed in a phone booth. Paul Hoff. Can he become the Superman Australia needs? Well inside the last 10. Gillespie. For the Australians, they'll be thinking about 1990, the Great Britain tour, and the big upset at Wembley Stadium. That pass looked forward. But Chris Johns still plays on. Eddinghausen. Every dollar invested by those at the ground and three sport on this test series are being paid in big dividends in this first test match. Marvellous game.
How many times do you see Melbourne Inga get the ball and be driven back 10 yards? You never see it. And he just was then.
Langer kicking behind Blackmore. What a second half for him. Botica takes it. And he gets taken by Clyde. Blackmore comes off his wing, trying to help his forwards out. The forwards who have really put up a great performance. Lonergan, he's still there. He got up off the canvas. One knockdown for him, but it was no knockout. He's come back to deliver his own blows to the Australians. They continue to work in the forwards. Now a switch to the backs. Friend, Tawrea and Nikau standing wide. Gets up quickly, taps it ahead. He turns the Australians around. Some tired Australians. Oh, this crowd is telling a story now here at Olympic Park. And they are roaring for New Zealand. They have so many supporters here. Marvellous effort from Nikau. He saw that no one was home. He shortened up the angle to the sideline. And he said, let's go down and put the heat on again.
Through the 80s, New Zealand's had Mark Graham, they've had Huey McGann, and this Tawrea and Nikau. He is another player that's carrying on that tradition. He's a fine, fine player.
Now, against the feed. New Zealand, they've got Mercer out there. He's only 3-4 metres away. Looking for another try. Another try to really rub it in. Mann. Mann stopped. Lewis hangs on to him. Mercer hears the call. They stay a short blindside. Todd, he's led the pack. They open up to the left. A big back line. Freeman to the in goal. Try! Oh, this is turning in to one of New Zealand's greatest ever test performances. It's Gary Freeman and his New Zealand Kiwis night tonight. What a moment for Bob Bailey. Freeman puts it along the deck. Hoff can't handle it. Nikau's on the spot on the Cadbury. Moro replay. Graham Lowe, quick thinking.
It was quick thinking, and watching these young fellows going here, Graham, there's a lot of things flash through your mind, but one of them that flashes through my mind is the next 5 or 6 years. New Zealand is still going to have these players playing test matches for them over the next 5 or 6 years. And that has spelled, that spells very, very good stead for the country.
Gary Freeman has rubbed it into everybody back at Balmain tonight. Botica rubs it in some more. What an effort.
I think they think they're playing France.
24-8. Bob Bailey is smiling. It is a beaming Bob Bailey. New Zealand make another change to enjoy some of the celebrations, to get a touch of what it's like to upset the Australians here in Melbourne. Mike Patton gets out there for what's left of this test match in Melbourne. Patton's out there for Williams. Langer. He throws Watson to the ground. Well, Huey, just how is that heart of yours sideline? Just a couple of problems to Huey McGann. We'll come back to him.
I'll tell you how it'd be, full of pride. Just how exactly the same as everybody watching this from back home. They'd be full of pride because these fellas have not only done the game of rugby league a lot of good, but for the Kiwis, they've done everybody marvellous.
Down it goes for Shearer. Well, Huey, as we were saying, just how proud do you feel tonight?
I feel on top of the world. I know how these players are feeling. They're running on heart. They're running on everything at the moment. They've taken the game to the Australians, come up with a win. They're all feeling happy out there, but they know there's a couple of minutes left to play. That's for them to finish off their job, and then they can do some celebrating after.
But, Huey, let's not just talk about character and pride. Let's talk about some skill tonight.
Exactly. You look at the likes of Richard Blackmore, someone who didn't, no one here would have known who Richard Blackmore was. They certainly know who he is now. He made Dal Shearer look second rate on more than one occasion.
Meninga. Well, the Australians went through Great Britain in 1986 and 82. They were called invincible. The Englishmen proved at Wembley last year that they weren't. New Zealand have done it in a much more determined fashion. They have put them away. Gillespie. We have to decide on a Ubix MVP tonight, Graham Lowe. That is one hell of a task.
Well, it is, because there's been a lot of fine performances out there. It's going to be very, very difficult, but I'm sure whoever gets it will share the thought and the pride and the prestige of it with the whole team.
A last throw of the dice here from the Australians. Johns to Clyde. Out of nowhere, it is that man. The man they call Freeman, like a thief in the night. They want some more. This New Zealand side and their supporters here in Melbourne want more tries. They want everybody in the rugby league world to stand up and ask just who are the champions at this game. Mann getting it back to George Mann, to Duane Mann. Nikau on the inside turning it. Patton, great hands from Botica. Friend, unwanted by the first grade sides in Sydney. Hasn't he come back with a vengeance tonight to haunt them?
Well, he has. I heard that he's been in good form, and he's shown it tonight. Another thing that's come through from this game, Graham, is that it shows that in the modern game of rugby league, the professional game of rugby league, the hard training game of rugby league, the game where it's very, very monotonous sometimes training, rigorous training, there is still a place for flair and enjoyment. And the Kiwis have shown it tonight. They've come out and shown flair, they've shown enjoyment, they've shown skill. Bob Bailey must be the proudest bloke.
He knows time's nearly up.
Well, fair dinkum, he's been under a lot of pressure from a lot of people. He must be so proud now, because he's got this young group of players together. This, before the game, you've got to really admit there probably wouldn't be one player who you could consider for the Australian side.
It may not be over. Blackmore, here it goes! If Patton could have held it, they could have been in again.
The saying is, you know, like the Kiwis, in all honesty, there's probably very few of them that you could have considered for the Australian side. And he has moulded this team. Bob Bailey has moulded this team into the unit. Teamwork has beat Australia tonight.
Lewis was trying something there. That's it! Stand up, New Zealand. These guys are on their feet. They have been on their feet all night. And they have produced one of your greatest performances in rugby league. Meninga's shattered. The Australian captain is shattered. We talked about this Cadbury-Moro Ultimate Test Series. They have achieved the ultimate tonight. They are going to go over, soak up every moment of this marvellous occasion. They're going to thank their fans. They have produced one of the great ones. It has been on foreign territory for both teams in a place called Melbourne. It's 24 points to 8. They still can't believe it. And this scene here, unbelievable. Let's take you down sideline with Clint Brown.
Okay, congratulations to the New Zealand team. Roy Hammond and the manager, you must be a very proud moment. Very proud moment for you and the team.
Well, we asked the players, we said it was all theirs. It was there for the taking. We said, you go get it, it's all yours. You've worked hard for it. Bob Bailey as well has worked very hard. And the message was, you go out and get it because they're takeable. And they went out and they did it. We're so proud, it wouldn't be funny.
Before the match, there was doubt that the boys could contain Australia within 20 points. Where did the inspiration for the win come from, Bob?
I believe it's in the makeup of the players themselves. They're a very harmonious team. They're all winners and they really try hard.
Okay. Any particular players stand out for you?
Brent, Todd and the forwards particularly. I thought Jarrod McCracken played very well in the back. And when Clayton and Freeman came on, the team seemed to spark that little bit extra. So I think it was a team effort, but to those three players, I think a little bit of thanks. And to Gary Freeman, probably the game of his life.
Can you believe the atmosphere here and the reception that this fantastic Kiwi team have received from the crowd here at Olympus Park in Melbourne?
I'm absolutely staggered. I haven't been involved in anything this big before, but I'm looking forward to the next time around. It's absolutely fantastic. It's stunning.
Emotional scenes here. Kiwi power reigns in Australia. Gary Freeman. Gary Freeman, if we can have a chat to you, mate. He's out there celebrating. Congratulations. That win, what does it mean to you from a personal note, Gary?
Oh, mate, it's for the team, you know. Personal note, I thought I played all right. And when Clayton came on, scored a great try. We worked pretty well together. So it'll be interesting to see what they do to Lexi's brother. The team every day, from 17 players, from Bob, the manager, Ray Everton, right through to the physios and doctors. Jazeera did a tremendous job, mate.
Down at halftime, do you think the guys had the guts to come back in that second spell?
Mate, we always had the guts to come back. We're just wondering if we could pull it out deep enough, and we did tonight. You know, especially with this crowd, mate, tremendous effort.
What about your thoughts when you were in the sin bin after 10 minutes? Do you think that could have been crucial?
Well, it was crucial for Australia because we scored, mate.
Congratulations, Gary Freeman. A very proud captain of the Kiwi League team. And joining us now, we've got Dave Watson and Bob Bailey. Bob Bailey, congratulations. Your
Thank
thoughts
you.
On that test victory?
Brilliant. The guys stuck to their guns, trained well all week. People wrote them off, said they weren't good enough, weren't tough enough. They did everything right.
What about that second half? Could you...
I believe we had to get in that second half at a better clip than we did the first half. First 10 minutes vital. That's what we did and we carried on from that. It was excellent.
The decision to use those reserves in the second spell, calculated move?
Right through, yeah, I wanted to do that, use the reserves up, which I seen was right at the time.
Okay, any players stand out from your point of view? That
come back with
you, mate.
Hi, Jim, how you doing? It's my wife.
Okay, great moments there for Bob Bailey. We certainly hope you enjoyed it, June, on TV3. There is the scene at Olympic Park here in Melbourne. It's been one of those rare occasions where New Zealand and the long history of test matches up against Australia has stood and delivered. We certainly hope you've enjoyed the action so far. We'll be back with more, with some of this amazing reaction and also to find out who wins the UBIX MVP player of the night. I'm losing my voice here because I've been losing my lungs out. We certainly hope you've enjoyed it. Stick around, we'll be back with more.
Keep it in!
The ultimate test between New Zealand and Australia. Proudly brought to you by Cadbury Moro. Wattie Soups presents the winter movie season. Saturday on 3's Family Night at the Movies.
My friends call me Biggles.
World War I ace meets modern day fast food manufacturer.
I fell through a hole in time.
Together they must destroy a German secret weapon.
Take over! Take over one! Just hold it!
Save the world.
Time has come for action.
With the help of a little modern machinery.
If you can fly a sock with cattle, you can fly anything.
And a whole lot of luck. Biggles, the family night of the movies, following the Generation Game, Saturday on 3.
We are reaffirming our commitment to building an airline that's the first choice for all discerning travelers. with a frequent flyer program that's without equal. In every detail, we'll offer a service that's second to none. A commitment that's reflected in everything we do for all travelers. We're making the world our home. Continental Airlines.
Okay, so to make this all work, we should take out our mortgage with you.
Yes, you should.
Because we've got the lot with them, they may start paying us interest on the cheque account. Yeah, doesn't sound right to me.
Sorry, could you go through that for us again?
Yeah, sure. It's called CheckLink, and it's a way of recognising the business you have with the bank. Here, have a look at this. Your mortgage, your cheque account, savings account, they all represent business we do together, and in your case, that comes to, over $73,000. So you're entitled to fee rebates, interest on your cheque account, and so on.
That's good.
So we'd actually be better off.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Bank of New Zealand, CheckLink. It's just one more way we're building a better bank.
Now you can wash and condition your hair every day in just one easy step with Dimension 2-in-1 from Mann in the old black bag.
When are you going?
Well, either red or green.
How much? Gee, that's cheap, Pierogi.
They've got little flowers on them. It's at Just Jeans.
Winter sale. Oh, I'd just get a couple of tops or something. $39.95.
So basically you get two for $95.
We won't do better than that for jeans.
You'd look good in them.
$64.95.
Just you.
Just me. Just jeans, where else?
Daniels with some more mobile magic. For this magic price, not only do you get one of these, but you also get a packet of Bluebird potato chips. And that applies when you buy these or these, you get your chips with these, or this. Okay? So, pick up your drink, pick up your chips with this magical mobile offer.
Welcome back to 3Sport, and joining us here once again is the Kiwi captain, Gary Freeman. Congratulations, you've just won the UBIX MVP Player of the Night for a great captain's knock. That certainly answered the critics, mate.
Oh, yeah, answered a few critics, but I think the team answered a few critics tonight. They got a lot of bagging in the papers over here by the Australian press, and like I just said before, it'll be very interesting to see what they say about the team now going into their second test.
All right, go away, congratulations. I know you want to get out there and get into it. That's the $2,000 worth of promotional products from UBIX, and we've got $10,000 overall for the series.
Mate, I'd just like to thank UBIX for the man of the match award. There was a lot of players out there that could have won it tonight, and I'm just very proud as a captain of this side to accept this award virtually nearly, I reckon, on behalf of the team, because it was a great team effort.
I know your wife Joanne is up there in the grandstand. Yeah. She's obviously wrapped tonight. Anyone back home in New Zealand you want to say hi to?
I'd just like to say a special thanks to all the supporters at faxed over to us and Kemp. Great support for us. And Tommy, happy 40th birthday, mate. Sorry I didn't ring you.
Okay, Gary Freeman, what a cracker. The other guy that finished second for the UBIX MVP Player of the Night award is Jarrod McCracken. You really had a cracker out there, mate.
Oh, yeah, well, I can't ask for any better, you know. First test match against Australia and we come up with a win. Static, that's all I can say.
And your own performance marking the big man, Mel Meninga.
Yeah, well, you know, they didn't use their strengths out wide, I thought. You know, they tried to take us on in the forwards. They thought that was going to be our weakest point, but, you know, guys like Brent, Todd and Peter Brown and those guys, you know, they held it up front and really stuck it to them. So, you know, they held it good.
What are your memories of that match-winning move there when you sent Richard Blackmore up for that try that broke the game open?
Oh, mate, happened that quick, I really can't remember it. But, you know, points on the board, that's what it's all about at the end of the day. And, you know, we come up with the victory.
Okay, fantastic stuff, Jarrod McCracken. Thanks for talking to us. The other guy also picks up a point tonight is Dean Lonergan. A fantastic effort by Cowboy after considering the fact that he went down with that knock, that cut to his head. He decided to stay there to avoid Disneyland. But I tell you what, they are celebrating like it is Disneyland tonight. So there it is. It's 24 to, what did the Australian score? They got 24 to 8. It was absolutely amazing. 24-8, New Zealand winning the big test tonight, the first test of the Capri Moro Ultimate Test Series. And let's go back to Eric Young in Auckland, because no doubt he'll be celebrating as well, just to confirm the UBEX MVP Player Awards for tonight.
Thank you, Clinton. Indeed, we are having a bit of a celebration here in the studio tonight, and this is the MVP, UBEX MVP Most Valuable Player Award, which will be given out at the end of this Ultimate Test Series. Well, let's take a look at the points in the MVP Player Awards. Here we go, Gary Freeman, 3 points tonight in the first test. Jarrod McCracken, what a wonderful second half from him, a great try. His dad, Ken, will be pretty thrilled with that. And Dean Lonergan, the Cowboy. Gary Freeman picks up a $2,000 promotional contract from UBEX. And at the end of the series, the winner gets a $10,000 UBEX promotional contract.
Well, what a scene has been created here in Melbourne tonight. The New Zealand Rugby League team, they came, they saw, and Graham Lowe, they have conquered the acknowledged world champions of the game.
Yeah, they have, Graham, and they've done it in style. They haven't done it by brute force or anything like that. They've done it by skill, flair, and they've done it by style.
Now, we're inside the Lion Red Kiwis dressing room, and there will be a little bit of that ale drunk tonight.
Certainly will. It's a good drop line, Red, and those guys will get plenty of it down their necks for sure.
Jarrod McCracken on test debut, and Lonergan, truly, Lowy, has there been a more courageous performance?
As I mentioned before, I've got to be honest, I have my doubts, but he come up trumps. Brent Todd there, I think Brent Todd was one of the unsung heroes. Look, he's held together by bits of string by the look of him, but he's done a great job for us.
And he used his bench well, he got all his squad out there. These guys are on an amazing high now for the second of our ultimate Capri Moro test.
Yeah, well, I felt that coming into this game was a great chance for New Zealand to win the first series for a long time, because there was good support for the Kiwis down here. They are a side that possesses a lot of flair. Bob obviously had them playing the right way. Those fellas sitting down there, look at Clayton, Friend. Everybody thought he was washed up player. They thought he'd finished. They thought he'd snuck off to the UK, but he's done a great job.
And a vital try and a great call by the referee, John Holdsworth.
It was a great call, and these Yorkshire blokes, they're a bit blind at times, but he's done the right job.
Not that you ever saw it any other way, but a try.
Yeah, well, I didn't really have any doubts, I thought. And even if it had been a knock-on, it would have been close enough.
And you keep on reminding me that I've lost my bet with you tonight.
No, I think that I'm sure all of New Zealand would have taken you to their hearts tonight as well, because you've come and represented the Kiwis on TV3 tonight, and I think you've added a professional style to the game, the calling of rugby league, and I think they'll want you back for plenty more calls.
Well,
I'll
tell you what, I've enjoyed it because I just love my sport, and I have seen one of the really great occasions. Now, this McCracken try, what a debut from this young man. What a buy the Canterbury Bankstown Club have on their hands.
Yeah, well, he slipped through our fingers.
Only about one that you have missed.
No, he's a fine player, and as I said before during the call, his father Ken McCracken only knew how to play the game hard.
Well, here's this Blackmore. Didn't he have a night out on the wing when he set that up? And he positioned McCracken perfectly. I was saying how proud I was to be part of the telecast, because I was lucky enough to be at Wembley with you last year when we called it for the Australians. And that was one of the really great occasions of an upset in sport. This has stolen it, as far as I'm concerned. Blackmore, young man out wide. Now, the train of thought here is he knew he had to set up McCracken.
Yeah, that's right. It was, when you look at the guy, he hasn't even been a winger for his all his playing career. He's been a forward. He's been put out on the wing, and they've adjusted him.
We're trying to keep the pitches coming to you here on 3 Sport. We're taking the 7 Network Australian coverage pitches here. Brown, big performer, great hands from Botica, and Blackmore gets to celebrate.
Yeah, that's right.
That was in the 23rd minute of the second half, and they were gone. Here he is, Richard Blackmore with Clint Brown.
Richard Blackmore, congratulations. What are your thoughts and those memories of those 2 great tries you scored there, mate?
Oh, I suppose I could just say that it's the best feeling I've had in my league since I've been playing.
The difference between playing France and then going out there and playing Australia tonight, what was it like?
Aussie being Aussie, well, I was just glad to go out there, and it was a hard game, as you can see by the face. They taught me a few things.
What about your own personal battle? I mean, you got the better of Dale Shearer twice there. Could you believe that second try when it just sort of popped out?
I was just happy just being there. You know, if you're there on the time, well, then it'll happen, it'll come to you.
No doubt you're glad you've made that switch from rugby union to rugby league. And your thoughts for the rest of the series?
Well, just stay in the full series, see if I can make each test as they come. That's basically it.
Okay, great stuff. Richard Blackmore. One other guy had a fantastic game tonight. Frano Botica, double All Black, now Kiwi and victorious against Australia. How does that game rate in your league career?
Probably the best game I've ever played and the biggest sort of win. It's awesome. Great to beat the Aussies, especially when they're the world champions. Obviously, we've still got a long way to go. There's two more games, and I'm sure the Aussies will come back, so we're just going to watch it.
Okay, Frano, thanks for talking to us, mate. Well, that's the scene here in Melbourne, live from Olympic Park. We're in the Kiwi dressing room. They are going to party tonight. Don't forget, there are two more test matches to come. And Wednesday, July 24, in Sydney, the second test. Wednesday, July 31, the third and final test at Glan Park. New Zealand hasn't won a test series since 1953. Perhaps this is the start of a great moment in Kiwi Rugby League. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you later on here on 3 Sports.